Welcome friends to my channel. Today we'll be making Sindhi kadhi. A lot of people did ask me to make this recipe since again it is super healthy and full of vegetables. So let's look at the ingredients that we need. So we need, of course, a heavy bottom pan. So I have put it on the gas already. And then we need oil. We need some coriander. We need some drumstick. Some green peas. Some fenugreek seeds or methi seeds. I'm using apple gourd also here. This is cluster beans, potatoes, lady finger, gram flour, curry leaves, ginger, mustard seeds. I have jeera here, salt, turmeric powder, red chili powder, hing. And I have taken about 6 tomatoes and I'll be adding chilies also and water. So let's start the recipe. You must be thinking why I have put the vegetables in water. Since it stays fresh till we are cooking, because this has its own process, you know, so you cannot put all the vegetables together. You need to put it, you know, one after the other. So there is a process. So you must understand the process here. So we are heating the pan. Now to the pan we will add some oil. So this is about 1/4 cup of oil nearly. Since we want the gram flour to be soaked completely and it has to be roasted well. So let the oil heat. And as soon as the oil heats, we'll add the fenugreek seeds to it. So this would be about a handful of fenugreek seeds. Depends on how much you're cooking. So this I'll be cooking like a full pan. So that's why the ingredients are little more. But if you want to cook half of the pan, then you can reduce the quantity accordingly. So you can see it's changing color. As soon as it changes color, we'll add the gram flour. And now we will reduce the flame. If your gram flour looks like this, that means you need additional oil. So we'll add about 2 tablespoons of oil more. Again, it depends on the texture of the gram flour. Some gram flours are very thin, some gram flours are thick. So it depends on the texture, how much oil you need for this. So you keep roasting till it turns brown. And again, it has to be on medium flame. You can see it is releasing oil. Now you can see it's changing color. To this we'll add half a tablespoon of turmeric powder and give it a stir. Now you have to continuously stir it, otherwise it will burn. As soon as you feel that the aroma of turmeric is gone, this is how it looks. Add water and continuously stir it, otherwise lumps are going to be formed. We have to add about 2 liters of water. More water. It may feel watery right now, but soon it will change its consistency. As we're going to be putting the vegetables and the other stuff, it will change its consistency. We'll give it a good stir. we'll allow it one boil. To this mixture, we will add the curry leaves. And our chilies. We have not done anything, we've just removed this, the top part, and we are adding the chilies. We'll allow it one boil. Now it's boiling. We'll add salt. Again, salt to taste. Give it a mix. With this, we'll add potatoes. Again, you can add any veggies of your choice. People put carrots, people put cauliflower. So you can have anything of your choice in this. Here I'm putting cluster beans. Drumstick. Peas. And apricot or tinda. Give it a mix. We'll cook these vegetables till half done. And once they are half done, we'll be adding the ladyfinger. We'll not add ladyfinger at this stage because it gets cooked very fast and the other vegetables would not be cooked. So we will add ladyfingers only after these vegetables are half done. And you have to increase the gas at this time to give it one boil and then decrease the gas. Now vegetables look half cooked. We can just insert a fork to check. See, it's half cooked. To this stage, we'll add our ladyfinger. And we'll allow it some cooking time till this is half done. In the meanwhile, we'll grind our tomatoes, ginger and chili and make a paste out of it. Now our lady fingers seem to be half done. I have pureed the tomatoes with ginger and chili. So I've added about a big 2-inch kind of ginger and about one chili and about 6 tomatoes. Now we're gonna strain this. You can also do it without straining. It depends on, you know, if you like the seeds and things like that inside the curry. Lot of people add tamarind to this curry, but I like the tomatoes flavor more. So if you want to add tamarind, you can reduce the quantity of tomatoes to half, and you know, just 5 minutes before your curry looks done, you can add a little bit of tamarind pulp. Want to avoid the skin and the seeds, that's why straining is important. Give it a mix. Again, increase the flame. Give it one boil. Then reduce the flame and cook it for next 15 to 20 minutes till the rawness of the tomatoes is gone. So now you can see the curry has changed its color and it's thickened up. Now we'll allow it be on the flame for some more time. In the meanwhile, we'll prepare the tadka. So I started a tadka pan. To this, I'll add about 4 teaspoon of oil. To this I'll add some mustard seeds. We'll allow it to crackle. Started to crackle. Now to this we'll add a teaspoon of jeera. At this stage we'll reduce the flame and we'll add some asafoetida or hing, about 1 teaspoon of it, and some Kashmiri chili powder. We'll switch off the flame, we'll add the Kashmiri chili powder, give it a stir and add it in the curry. At this stage, we'll cover the curry for about 2 minutes so that all the aroma of the tadka is in, and we'll give it another 15 minutes of boiling time. Now the curry looks done. We'll add coriander to this. Give it a stir. And it's ready to be served. So our curry is done, and this is how the color looks. It's thickened up also. Thank you friends for watching my recipes. I'm really glad to hear from you guys, and I would love to try more recipes for you. If you like my recipes, do press the bell icon to subscribe to my channel, and so that you keep getting updates also on my recipes. And I look forward to your comments, and once you try the recipes, do post pictures and your comments how the recipe turned out to be. Thank you so much.